God is crucified. He has died. Today, we remember that truth was crucified. Love was crucified. Take a moment and imagine something with me. Imagine how the crucifixion of Jesus looked to the disciples. It seems the father of lies has won. Death and indifference have won. The great Messiah, my long-awaited leader and king, is dead. Imagine how the disciples must have felt. Can you feel their loss, their confusion, their agony and desperation, even their despair? They must have felt so oppressed, so lost. But you know what? What we're imagining isn't just the disciples then. We're really coming to know our own lives now. The lives of our neighbors and friends, our families, our cities, our world. In this postmodern time, in this post-Christian age, for too many people, he just isn't there. God truly seems dead. And no one seems to be mourning. But there's hope. I have hope. And so should you. Somehow, mysteriously, while truth and love descended into the grave, hope did not. Somehow, the great Christian witness to hope remained, like a little child standing beside the grave of her father, waiting for him to wake up, to get up, to hold her. Hope stood strong, because hope trusts. When we remember the crucifixion, we see it through the lens of the glorious resurrection we know is coming. So we can hope, just like the child. This hope has the power to transform falsehood, hatred, indifference, and apathy into truth and love. Because hope is transformative. It's not just about things to come. To have hope within us today changes who we are today, here, now. Choosing to trust in the face of what so many others think and believe and assert, that's the secret. That's the power of the gospel. That God is on the cross is no scandal. It's the key to unlocking everything, every mystery, every confusion, every doubt. And it depends on simple trust, that hope is powerful. It explains why, in another small paradox of Good Friday, when we grieve at the loss of Christ on the cross, we cling to the hope that he promises. It is ours to keep, that we too will see his resurrection, to be taken up in his resurrection. This is our gift. This is what he's given us. So I want to challenge you with something. Something simple, but something that can be life-changing. I want you to ask God for an increase in your hope. I want you to ask him to increase your trust in him. If you think you can't or somehow just don't want to, ask yourself, why? Why can't you ask him to help you? Why won't you? If you think you can't because you're unworthy, you've missed the whole point of the cross. He died on that cross for you. So you don't have to. You don't have to feel worthy. He is worthy, and he chose you. He chooses you. So do this for yourself. Let yourself be surprised. Today, when Christians worldwide remember his death on the cross, let your hope increase. See for yourself why Christians are the prophets of hope. Stand strong in your hope. Jesus changes everything.